Hello everyone and welcome to this video where I'm going to tell you that how you can call anonymous third-party REST APIs in SharePoint framework. So let's get started. So the steps which we are going to perform in this particular video to call anonymous third-party REST APIs in SPFX are on your screen. So first of all, we will create a SPFX solution using Yeoman Generator. And for this, I'm going to use React as the framework. And this particular steps I have already performed. This particular step means I have already created a solution having React as the framework. Then we are going to update the public interface for the React component. Then we will implement the user interface for the web part. After that, we will implement the web part logic. And finally, we will test the web part. So let's jump to Visual Studio Code, where I have already opened the solution. Okay, so the solution is SPFX HTTP client. This is the solution name. And in this solution, you can see there is a SRC folder. Inside it, there is web parts, components. So this is the complete solution structure of a typical SPFX web part. So first of all, we have to update the public interface for the React component. So I am opening the file. That is ispfx http client props.ts. So this file is the interface for the public properties on the React component. We will update the interface to replace the existing description property. You can see here that there is a default description property which comes with every SPFX web part. I have added my own custom property with the name Apollo image. So this is the change which we have done in this particular file. So remember this step. This is the step where we have updated the interface, public interface for the React component. So this is the first step. Now coming to the second step, what we have to do, we have to implement the user interface for the web part. So for this, we have to do two things. First, I will go to SCSS file just to add some styling to this web part. For that, I have added this class .list. And another class which I've added at the end of the file is .item. So these two things you need to add in the .scss file. After that, you have to navigate to TSX file and update the render method. So I've opened the TSX file. You can see here spfx http client.tsx. And you have to update the markup. You have to update the markup for the render method, which is in the TSX file. What it will do, it will create a list using CSS classes where each item displays an image. So in this particular render method, what I have done, where I've made the changes, these are the changes particularly which I've made. So first it will do, it will show the image in the output. First it will show the image, which will be fetched from the third party REST API. Second, it will show the title. And third, it will show the keywords. And in that keywords, since it's a collection of the keywords, so I have used map function to iterate over that collection of keywords. So this is the second thing. So I'm repeating once again. First, what we did, we updated the public interface for the React component. Second, we have updated the render method in the TSX file. Now the last step of this video is implementing the web part logic. So let's open the TS file, that is the main web part file, that is spfx http client webpart.ts. So this is the TS file. In this TS file, what I have done is I have added a method. But before this, please remember, you have to add some import statement, that is import http client and import http client response at the top of this file. Once you have done that, you have to add a method. In this case, I have added, you can see here, a get image method. Now what is happening in this? This method uses the HTTP client available. So you can see here, this.context.http client.get. So this method uses the HTTP client available from the current SharePoint context and issues an HTTP get request to the third party image REST API with the query equal to Apollo 4. You can see over here that this is a third party anonymous REST API which I am using and going to consume in this particular demo, which says images api.nasa.gov/search ?q is equal to Apollo 4. Okay, so after processing the response to JSON, here the response in the JSON format will be processed. It's returned to the caller as an untyped any object. Okay, so this is the particular method which I have added. Now after that, you need to update the render method. I have added something in the render method also. So what I am doing in the render method, so I have updated the contents of the render method, wherein I have added a check to see if the web part, I have added a check by using the if statement to see if the web part has already been rendered on the page. If not, then it again calls the getImage method which has been previously added. When it receives the response, it attaches the first item, because you can see over here response.collection.item 0. So what it is doing, whenever it receives a response, it attaches the first item in the results, which is returned by the third party image REST API. So these are the steps which I followed to call an anonymous third party REST API in SPFX web part. So now it's time to test this web part. For that, I have already opened the Node.js command prompt, and I am going to write the command gulp serve to test this particular web part on the local workbench. So I'm going to press enter now. So now, as you can see, it has ran and going to build the solution and starting the server. You are ready to test the web part on the local workbench. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this plus icon and going to add the web part which we have added in the solution. So this is the name of the web part. So once the web part will be added, you will see over here, this is showing the Apollo 4 launch image with its title and some of the keywords. So these are the keywords. So that's what we wanted as per the code which we have written. So again, I'm repeating the main step for consuming the third party anonymous REST API. The main thing is that you have to use this.context.http client.get, which is available from the current SharePoint context. So that's all in this video. You can find the link of the code which I have shown you in the description of this video. Do like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks again. Thank you for watching this video.